Hello, anatomy friends. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to station number 9, where we are going to talk about the muscles associated with the scapular region. These are often referred to as intrinsic shoulder muscles or scapulohumeral muscles. So those that have some form of attachment on the scapula, but its distal attachments are going to be on the humerus. So let's start with the big one, which is the deltoid muscle. This I often think of as kind of the shoulder cap. It is covering the shoulder. It makes that rounded contour that we associate with the shoulder. And it is shaped like an inverted delta. So a delta is, that Greek letter is going to be like this. So it's kind of a upside down inverted one of those. And it is going to have proximal attachments not only on the acromion and the spine of the scapula, so you can see the spine right here, the acromion is that point of the shoulder here, but it also has some attachment on the clavicle as well, and then its distal attachment's going to be on the humerus. So I think a fairly obvious muscle if you're thinking about just covering that shoulder joint region. You can see a bit of the posterior rotator cuff muscles, and we're looking at a posterior view because there's that spine of the scapula. I keep bringing that up over and over again in terms of a posterior view. So I always try to find those few things that'll help kind of clue me in to what I'm looking at. So superior to that scapular spine, you're going to have the supraspinatus, which you can see just a little of here. And then inferior to the scapular spine, you will have the infraspinatus, which is the larger one, and then the teres minor, which is the small muscle right here. And then this is teres minor, this larger muscle right here, which is not a rotator cuff muscle, is the teres major. One we're not gonna have you identify, just because we're gonna focus mainly on these rotator cuff muscles. This particular view is showing the posterior region with the deltoid muscle removed, so you can really see these posterior rotator cuff well, and you can also see where their distal attachments are. So again, here is that scapular spine, here is the acromion. So this is the supraspinatus, which is in the supraspinous fossa, and it kind of goes under the acromion in order to have its attachment on the greater tubercle. The infraspinatus, as you can see, is this larger muscle here, and the teres minor. And all three of these are going to have their distal attachments on that greater tubercle. And sometimes, and on these images, and if it were in a practical setting, you would be able to distinguish between these two muscles, but sometimes it is very difficult to tell the difference between the infraspinatus and the teres minor. And just to kind of get our bearings, this is teres major. This is part of the triceps. And then this is actually your latissimus dorsi. So you remember that superficial back muscle that extends all the way to the humerus. Here we're looking at an anterior view. This is going to be the shoulder joint region. This is showing a ligament that's going over the intertubercular sulcus. But what I want you to focus on is this large muscle right here, which is your subscapularis. Now I'm looking at an anterior view because I can see that coracoid process right here. So the subscapularis muscle is very thick, it's triangular, and key, it is anterior. It is your only anterior rotator cuff muscle. And it is going to have its muscle belly right on this anterior or costal side of the scapula. And then its distal attachment will be on the lesser tubercle over in this region. And you can see that basically it's really difficult to tell the difference when you get to about here between the tendon and the articular capsule because it is forming that anterior portion of the rotator cuff. Okay, excellent. So thank you for your time and attention here. And please make sure to reach out if you have any questions on the identification of these structures. See you at the next station.